Hi guys, today we are going to see the detailed solution for week 3 assignment. So the first question they are asking about the sum of the deviations about mean. Whenever you consider sum of the deviations about mean, it will be always be equals to 0. Okay, this is a theory question. You can check the videos for the solution. And coming to the mode of the normal distribution. In the mode of the normal distribution, how can you consider which symbol is related to the mode of the normal distribution is for normal distribution, mean and mode will always be equal to this. Okay. So here, if you see, they told that the normal distribution, the mode and the medium are the same as the mean. The mean for the normal distribution represented by mu. So obviously, mode and medium will be same as the mean. So mean is represented by u. So mode will also be represented by mu symbol. Okay. Next question is, for the positively skewed distribution, the extreme values will lie in. Positively skewed distribution is the one, is a distribution in which you'll be having more outliers on the right tail, okay? On the right hand side, you'll be having more values, okay? Or I can say more outliers on the right hand side. That's why I can just say the extreme values will be lying in the right hand, right tail of the distribution. For the explanation part, you can go to the solutions and see. For the positively skewed distribution, that is called as right skew distribution, is a type of distribution in which most values are clustered around the left layer of the distribution, while the right tail of the distribution is longer. Okay, so more extreme values, that is nothing but outliers, will be lying in the right hand of the distribution. That's why we need to choose the right tail of the distribution option. So next, the domain of T distribution, the T distribution domain will be minus infinity to plus infinity. Okay. The statistical power of a test is denoted by beta will be representing false. Beta will be representing false negative. So true positive is nothing but is called as power of the test. So, if 1 minus b will be representing the true positive. So, false negative is also called as type 2 error, guys. Type 2 error is nothing but it is used for not rejecting the null hypothesis. And 1 minus beta will assure us, will tell us that you can reject the null hypothesis. Okay. So, here they're asking which one of the following can represent statistical power of a test. So the option will be 1 minus beta. Beta is nothing but false negative. Okay. So 1 minus beta will be true positive. Remember that. So that will give you a power of the test. These are theory questions. So I'm just saying directly. So if type 1 error decreases, type 1, type 2 are totally opposite to each other. So whenever type 1 is decreasing, type 2 will increase. Okay. So if you see the explanation part here, type 2 error is called as false negative. That is, I already told you, type 2 error will tell us of not rejecting the null hypothesis. That is, you have to accept the null hypothesis, while the alternative hypothesis is true state of nature. So false positive, type 1 error will give you false positive and type 2 error will give you false negative. Okay. So, if whenever type 1 error is decreasing, obviously a type 2 error will increase because these two are totally opposite to each other. That is what you have to remember. Okay. So, now next, come to this question where they have given us a data set, that is seedbelts.csv, which is having different variables or columns, I can say. Here, month, driver skill, drivers, friend, rare, kilometers, petrol price, van killed, and law. So in law, you have only one value, I mean two values, 0 and 1. 0 indicates that law was not in effect, where 1 indicates that law is in effect. Okay. So here, these are the different variables. So they're asking us the average number of car drivers killed after the law was in effect is. So we need to find the number of car driver skill, okay, driver skill, we have a column, right? How many number of drivers got killed when the law was in effect, after the law was in effect? So I can say that after the law was in effect means that I need to find the drivers, the number of drivers who got killed when after the law was in effect is nothing but I need to filter the data using the condition saying that law value is not equals to zero, right? Because that is our question. The average number of car drivers killed after the law was in effect is. Okay. So let's just come to the RStudio. I've already loaded this package DPL by R because I need to filter the data set. So how can I read the data set that I'm going to see now? I already told you as it is related to, just let me download this data set first. So it's downloaded. I'll just try to rename the data set. I'll just give the name as seat belt rather than seat belts because I already have the data set. Seat belt, I'll give. Okay. So let me copy the location of the data set also. So I need to load the data set first into my studio, date.csv of the location. So seatbelt.csv. So here, seat belt data, I'm just storing it in this way. Okay, it got loaded. So how many observations? 192 observations of 11 variables. Now, what do I need to do? I need to filter this data. So using, what's the condition? I need to find out the number of drivers killed or data, like when the law was effective, right? So I'll just try to filter that first. So here I'm writing the condition filter of the condition should be which data I'm going to filter, that is seat belt, comma. Seat belt data dot dollar of law is not equals to zero. Okay. So we will be getting only those rows where law equals to effective. So I need to store this in some variable. So I'm just writing as law effect data. Okay, so we got 23 observation, 11 variables. Okay, now from this observation, I filtered the data using the law equals to 1. Now I need to find the total number of average number of drivers killed, right? So how can I get the data is, I can just say, if I say law effect data dollar drivers killed, then I'll get this data, okay? But I need to calculate the whole summary of that. I need to calculate the average, right? Average number of drivers killed after the law was in effect. So how can I do that is, I'll just take a summary of this one. So I got this one. So you just need to consider the main data. So 100 is your main data. Okay. So this will be your average number of car drivers, that is 100. Okay. So next, how many frenzied passengers were injured or killed in the year 1984? Okay. How can you calculate that? Is again using the filter. Okay. Again, you have to use the filter command and you have to filter out with the condition saying that the year 1984, right? Year is 1984 and injured number of van drivers killed. So what did they ask us? Yes, they ask us the frenzied passengers, right? So number of frenzied passengers from this data, you can get it. So now let's go there. So I'm trying to filter this using year, year equals to, what's the year they have given us? 1984, right? 1984. And what do we need it? The number of, right? So this I'm storing year data. Okay, if I do your data, I'll be getting this one. So I need to find the number of drivers killed in this particular year, right? I can just do a summary of this one or a friend passengers killed. Friend. Okay. Just get this one. Okay. So I just need to find the summary of this. This should be answer. The maximum values will be 1 minute. I think somewhere I missed it. The total you have to find it out actually. If I do the total sum of this whole data, sum of peer data, dollar, friend, then that will give me the total number of passengers, I mean frenzied passengers who got killed in a year. 1984. So what did I do earlier? I just filtered this data. Okay. Seatbelt of data is the data which I stored it. And in that, what did I do? Using this seatbelt, I filtered the seatbelt data using the condition 1984. And that year data I got stored in year data. And next from this, what did they ask us? They asked us that. How many friends seat passengers were injured or killed in the year 1984. Okay. So, when I did year data or this one, year data of friend, then I got this whole, these are number of passengers. Okay. Just I take the sum of this one, then I'll just get it, get the total value of the passengers killed. Or injured, okay, 7047. That's how we can do it. Next, they're asking us calculate the variances for the variables friend rare. Okay, so how can you calculate the variables for the friend and rare is nothing but wear off seat belt data of friend. So this will be your value 30659.65. And next is, they ask us to calculate the rare column variance also. This is a predefined command, guys. Var and variant. If you want to know the variance in the RStudio, you have to use var command. Okay. So these are two options. So what did they say us? They're asking us variance of friends with passengers greater than variance of rare seat passengers or it's less than. let's compare these two values. So what's the answer, guys? So how many points do we have here? 30659.65. So obviously, friend will be greater than compared to rare, right? Second option. Variance of friends is passengers is greater than variance of friends. So maximum kilometers driven by the driver. So how can you calculate the maximum kilometers driven by the driver? Nothing but I can just take the summary of seatbelt data, dollar, you have kilometers, right? Maximum kilometers. If I do this one, you need to select the maximum value, 21626. That's it. So this will be your maximum kilometers driven by the driver. So that is how you can calculate this one, guys. So sometimes what will happen is, he might given you the summary of this one, this output he can give you, and he can directly ask from this image, what can you consider, what should be the answer for this maximum value, right? Maximum kilometers driven by the driver, then you can just choose the last column. Like that, they can ask you the questions. Okay. So they will not just give you the data set and just give you this question, guys. Okay. They will give you the output, and from the output, they can ask you to conclude what might be the answer. So in this way, you might get the questions related to the studio. Okay. I hope it is clear. Thank you for watching.